The webinar today will deal with the benefits of the Strep-Tag System 3. When we talk about the third generation Strep-Tag system or Strep-Tag System 3, we in principle talk about Strep-Tactin XT in combination with Twin-Strep-tag. To get a better understanding on the differences of the Strep-Tag systems, I'll give you a short introduction to the Strep-Tag system at the beginning, and then I will focus on the benefits of Strep-Tactin XT. Let's start with a general introduction to the Strep-Tag system. The Strep-Tag system is based on the biotin-streptavidin interaction, which is one of the strongest non-covalent interactions in nature. Based on the system, a peptide was engineered, which binds to the biotin binding pocket of streptavidin with high affinity, and it was named Strep-Tag-1. Unfortunately, this peptide could only be used at the C-terminus of a recombinant protein. Therefore, it was systematically optimized and then called Strep-Tag-2. To further improve the binding affinity, streptavidin was mutated and then named Strep-Tactin. The so-called second-generation Strep-Tag system is used for more than 2 decades in protein purification. However, it is not really suitable for high-affinity applications such as SPR or low-abundant protein. The system was further improved. First, the Twin-Strep-tag was engineered, which consists of 2 Strep-Tag-2 motifs in series. Due to this avidity effect, the binding affinity to Strep-Tactin increases, dependent on the recombinant protein, up to 1000-fold. Also, Strep-Tactin was further optimized to improve the binding affinity, and it was named Strep-Tactin XT. Together, Strep-Tactin XT and Twin-Strep-tag are the third generation of the Strep-tag system. To better understand the differences of the binding affinities within the Strep-tag system, I have prepared this overview. This shows the binding affinities of the ligands biotin, Strep-Tag-2 and Twin-Strep-tag to the receptor streptavidin, Strep-Tactin and Strep-Tactin XT. The biotin-streptavidin binding is one of the strongest in nature. It has a binding affinity in the femtomolar range. Since the biotin binding pocket of Strep-Tactin was mutated, its binding affinity for biotin is reduced compared to streptavidin, and it is further decreased for the biotin-streptactin XT binding. In contrast, Strep-Tag-2 has a low binding affinity to streptavidin, and due to an altered biotin binding pocket of Strep-Tactin, the binding affinity for Strep-Tag-2 is increased. Strep-Tag-2 has a binding affinity to Strep-Tactin XT in the nanomolar range. The same is true for Twin-Strep-Tag. It has a low binding affinity for streptavidin, and it is increased for Strep-Tactin and Strep-Tactin XT. The binding affinity for Strep-Tactin XT is in the picomolar range. Next, we have a look at the very easy and straightforward purification cycle of the Strep-Tag system. It will show the purification of a recombinant protein carrying a Twin-Strep-tag and using Strep-Tactin XT as purification resin. The quick purification process includes 2 specificity conferring steps, which allow the purification of highly pure proteins after a single purification cycle. This purity is usually above 98%. The 1st specificity conferring step occurs during lysate application. It is a highly specific binding of the Twin-Strep-tag with the resin. After this, wash of the column is performed using a physiological buffer like PBS. The tendency of Strep-Tactin or Strep-Tactin XT to bind non-specific proteins is very low. And physiological buffer conditions have the advantage that the bioactivity of enzymes or protein-protein interactions will be preserved. Then the 2nd specificity conferring step follows. It is a competitive elution using biotin for Strep-Tactin XT. It allows the concentrated elution of the target protein in a sharp peak. Finally, the resin is regenerated by addition of low-concentrated sodium hydroxide. Then the resin can be reused at least 3 to 5 times, but most people use it 10 to 20 times or even more. If you compare the purification cycle of Strep-Tactin and Strep-Tactin XT, you will see that there are only 2 changes in the procedure. For both, first the lysate is applied and then the column is washed. Here the same buffers can be used for those 2 steps. But for elution, the procedure differs. For elution from Strep-Tactin, you should use desthiobiotin. If you use biotin, the resin will be blocked irreversibly. For Strep-Tactin XT, you have to use biotin because desthiobiotin is not strong enough to elute the protein efficiently. Also, the regeneration differs. For Strep-Tactin, you can use HABA. It is a yellowish solution which turns red upon binding to Strep-Tactin. It thereby competes with the desdiobiotin for the binding site. The color change also serves as kind of a quality control for the resin. As long as HABA changes its color on the resin, it can be reused. HABA can be easily removed from the resin by addition of PBS or a similar physiological buffer. In case of Strep-Tactin XT, low concentrations of sodium hydroxide can be used for regeneration. After this, also HABA can be applied as a quality control, but it cannot be used for regeneration. The second part of this talk will deal with the benefits of Strep-Tactin XT and what makes the system superior to the second generation Strep-Tag system and to all other affinity tags. On one hand, it has new features. Strep-Tactin XT has a near covalent binding affinity for Twin-Strep-tag, and with this, higher protein yields can be purified. On the other hand, it can be used in new applications. It can be used for purification under denaturing conditions, batch purification, and immobilization for assays. On the next slides, we will have a closer look into the new features and applications. Strep-Tactin XT in combination with Twin-Strep-tag has an improved binding affinity. This was achieved by optimization of the biotin binding site of Strep-Tactin XT for Strep-tag, which results in a better on-rate of the interaction. The other effect influencing the binding affinity is a reduced off-rate, which is achieved due to an avidity effect of Twin-Strep-tags. Since it has two Strep-Tag 2 motifs in series, it can have two different stages of binding to Strep-Tactin XT. One is the binding of both motifs and the other is the transient release where only one of the two Strep-Tag 2 motifs bind to Strep-Tactin XT. This reduces the off-rate without hampering the reversibility of the interaction, which is achieved by addition of biotin. The high binding affinity and low K-off rate results in a more stable binding of Twin-Strep-tag and Strep-Tactin XT. This allows, for example, a more intense wash during the purification procedure. This we show here with the Twin-Strep-tag M-Cherry fluorophore, which was purified on Strep-Tactin and Strep-Tactin XT in parallel. For the purification via Strep-Tactin, we usually recommend to use 3 to 4 column volumes. In this experiment here, we have done 8 wash steps, each one column volume in size. And what you see in the collected wash fractions here and on the SDS gel is that some of the protein is eluted from the Strep-Tactin resin during these wash steps, while no tag protein is washed down from Strep-Tactin XT. This shows that using Strep-Tactin XT for purification prevents the loss in yield during the wash steps when intensive washing is required. Another benefit resulting from the improved binding kinetics are higher yields, which can be achieved per milliliter resin. For this, we have loaded the same amount of Twin-Strep-tag M-Cherry protein on 1 milliliter gravity flow columns of Strep-Tactin and Strep-Tactin XT. And what you see is that the maximum binding capacity of the Strep-Tactin column was already achieved while only the upper third of the Strep-Tactin XT column was occupied. Further, we have measured the maximum protein yield which can be purified via 1 milliliter gravity flow columns via Strep-Tactin and Strep-Tactin XT. These data show that the binding capacity of Strep-Tactin XT versus Strep-Tactin is up to 2 times higher. This is of course dependent on the recombinant protein, but in the range of the binding capacity which can be achieved with IBA Strep-Tactin high capacity resin, and with this is a more economic alternative to our Strep-Tactin high capacity resin. Strep-Tactin XT has also advantages for the purification of membrane proteins. For the purification of membrane proteins, often detergents are required. They are required to keep the protein in solution. Shown on this SDS page here, is that the interaction of Twin-Strep-tag to Strep-Tactin XT is very stable in the presence of commonly used detergents. The yields of purified protein was independent to the added detergent which were used at a concentration of 2%. A list with tested reagents on Strep-Tactin XT can be downloaded from our homepage or requested via email. Strep-Tactin XT also allows the purification under denaturing conditions using up to 6 molar urea. And to show this and how good this works, we have compared the system with the HisTag system and with Strep-Tactin. For HisTag, we use the recommended standard protocol, which allows the usage of up to 8 molar urea. The first elution step is then done at pH 5.9, and the second elution step needs to be done at pH 4.5, where finally the target protein is eluted. For purification on Strep-Tactin, we used only 4 molar urea, showing that Strep-Tactin is not suitable for purification under denaturing conditions. For purification via Strep-Tactin XT, we recommend to use up to 6 molar urea. This purification results in highly pure protein at high yield if you compare this to the His-Nickel NTA purification. With this, purification under denaturing conditions is now possible using the Strep-Tag System 3. And the advantage is that you only need one elution step, which makes the whole purification more simple. So far, batch purification using the Strep-Tag system did not work in a sufficient and efficient manner. But using Strep-Tactin XT on magnetic beads, this allows the batch purification in Strep-Tag quality, which means in high purity. As shown in this example here, crude bacterial extract was applied to the Strep-Tactin XT magnetic beads, and the target protein was eluted with biotin. The bioanalyzer data show that the purity of the GFP Strep-Tag protein is beyond 95%. You can also elute the target protein by boiling. For this, the STS sample buffer is added directly to the beads and then boiled. Also here, a purity of more than 95% was achieved. Besides the target protein, also Strep-Tactin XT is eluted from the beads, and it runs at 30 kilodalton. So please keep this in mind if you do elution by boiling. The most important benefit of Strep-Tactin XT is that in combination with Twin-Strep-tag, it can be used for high affinity applications and assays or even assay development. Twin-Strep-tag fusion proteins can be efficiently immobilized on different surfaces like microtiter plates, chips, and so on. While the option for mild elution is preserved for these applications, 96-well microtiter plates are also suitable for small-scale purifications as needed, for example, for screenings of targets. To demonstrate the efficiency of the system, we have done a BAP assay. It is a bacterial alkaline phosphatase assay. Here the BAP was fused with either Strep-Tag 2 and Twin-Strep-tag, and the protein was immobilized on either Strep-Tactin or Strep-Tactin XT microtiter plates. Then we measured the relative substrate turnover resulting from the alkaline phosphatase activity. This comparison of the two tags on the two resins shows that the immobilization of Strep-Tag 2 on Strep-Tactin is not really efficient because the relative signal intensity is quite low. This results from a fast dissociation of the tag from the resin. Twin-Strep-tag binds Strep-Tactin much more stable. Therefore, the relative signal intensity is almost 2.5-fold higher. Both tags bind very tightly to Strep-Tactin XT. Here, the signal intensity is 3.5 and 4-fold higher. Immobilization on Strep-Tactin XT is so efficient that there is only a minor difference between Strep-Tag 2 and Twin-Strep-tag. The high binding affinity and stable binding of Twin-Strep-tag to Strep-Tactin XT can also be used for biocore SPR measurements. In these sensor crumbs here, you see the immobilization of a Twin-Strep-tag protein on either Strep-Tactin or Strep-Tactin XT. The K-on rate of Strep-Tactin XT is much faster, and also the stability of the interaction is much more stable due to a lower K-off rate. Therefore, Strep-Tactin XT is highly suitable for this kind of immobilization experiments. Finally, I want to give an overview on the applications for which Strep-Tactin XT and Twin-Strep-tag should be used. If you have a concentrated cytosolic expressed protein, you can use either tag and either resin. It all works pretty nicely. But if you have a diluted protein, which is, for example, secreted protein to the medium, you should either use the Twin-Strep-tag in combination with Strep-Tactin, or you can use the Strep-tag or the Strep-Tag 2 or the Twin-Strep-tag in combination with Strep-Tactin XT. For batch purification, we recommend to use the Twin-Strep-tag in combination with Strep-Tactin XT. Purification under denaturing conditions is only recommended for Strep-Tactin XT because Strep-Tactin is not stable under denaturing conditions. And here you achieve the best results if you use the Twin-Strep-tag in combination with Strep-Tactin XT. For detection, it doesn't matter which combination of the tools you are using. If you want to do assay development or immobilization approaches, you should also use the Twin-Strep-tag in combination with Strep-Tactin XT, because here you can make use of the high binding affinity and achieve the best results. With this, I'm at the end of my presentation, and for any questions, please do not hesitate to contact us under Strep-Tag at iberlifesciences.com.